In this video guide, we are going to see how to seize FSMO rules using PowerShell. So the question is, why we need to seize FSMO rules when we can simply transfer it from one domain controller to other? The answer is, you need to seize FSMO rules when the original FSMO rule holder goes offline or becomes non-operational permanently. In that case, you cannot transfer FSMO rules because the current domain controller is not online. Therefore, the only solution is you need to seize FSMO rules. Generally, seizing FSMO rules is used as a last option when nothing works in our favor. You need to try to recover your domain controller which holds all FSMO rules. If you fail to do that, then you can go with seizing FSMO rules. For this demo, we have single domain Active Directory forest named mylib.local, and we have a two domain controller in our domain mylib.local. The first one is WS2K19-DC01, which is currently holds all 5 FSMO rules, and the second one is WS2K19-DC02, which is additional domain controller for mylib.local domain. And we are assuming that due to hardware failure, we are not able to bring WS2K19-DC01 online, so we need to seize the FSMO rules and want to assign to WS2K19-DC02. So first of all, let's open Windows PowerShell. For that, I'm going to right click on Start button and let's select Windows PowerShell Admin. The first thing which we need to do is let's verify which domain controller currently holds all 5 FSMO rules. And for that, we can use command netdomqueryfsmo. As you can see, Schema Master, Domain Naming Master, PDC, RID, and Infrastructure Master, all 5 FSMO rules are currently assigned to WS2K19-DC01, and which domain controller is now in a non-operational mode. So we want to seize these rules and want to assign to WS2K19-DC02. To do that, we need to run command move-ad directory server operation master rule. Then after, we need to specify the switch-identity to specify the name of the server where we want to assign these FSMO rules, which will be a WS2K19-DC02 in our case. Then we need to specify switch-operation master role to specify the name of FSMO role which we want to seize. It will be a schema master, comma domain naming master, comma PDC, comma RID, comma infrastructure. Now we need to specify one more switch, and that is very important to seize FSMO role, which is -force. The only change in the command from FSMO role transfer is the -force switch at the end of this command. Now it's time to press enter key, and it is asking us that, do you want to move role to server ws2k19-dc02.mylib.local? Say if you press Y, then it will ask again for domain naming master, PDC emulator, RID, and infrastructure master. And that's why I'm not going to press Y, I'm going to press A, which is yes to all, and we need to press enter key. This command will take few minutes to complete, as in the background, it will try to connect to original FSMO role holder, and if the connection is unsuccessful, that time this command will start seizing FSMO rules from existing domain controller and will assign to WS2K19-DC02 domain controller. After waiting few minutes, command execution has been completed successfully. Now let's again run command netdomqueryfsmo to see the information about current FSMO role owners. And as you can see, schema master, domain naming master, PDC, RID, and infrastructure master, all 5 FSMO roles are currently assigned to WS2K19-DC02.mylib.local domain controller. That means we have successfully seized FSMO roles from DC01 to DC02. Let's go to Active Directory Users and Computer Snapping as well. And here you can see our DC02 is also configured as a global catalog server. That means now we can say our DC02 is configured as a primary domain controller for mylib.local domain, as it holds all 5 FSMO roles, as well as this DC is a global catalog server. One more thing which you need to remember is once cease process complete, the old FSMO rule holder should not be bring online again. It is highly recommended to format and remove it from your local network. So that's it for this video demonstration on how to cease FSMO rules using Windows PowerShell. Thank you all for watching this video.